Getting our masks earlier this year might have been a huge relief, but these last few months have been a time of enormous uncertainty and fear for about 12 million Americans who are dealing with suppressed immune systems because of conditions like rheumatoid arthritis, Crohn's disease, or ongoing organ transplant treatment. For them, the easing of COVID restrictions is only making life more dangerous.
It's really a very difficult situation for these people that are immunosuppressed.
Dr. Edward Oldfield is an infectious diseases expert with Eastern Virginia Medical School. He says about 4% of the population is immunosuppressed because of conditions they have or medications they take.
Cancer or transplant or lupus or rheumatoid arthritis or Crohn's disease. Because of this increased risk of severe disease, all of these people need to get vaccinated.
But in a cruel twist, in transplant patients, the vaccine response is particularly poor.
And only about half develop any antibody response at all.
That affects people like Doris Pittman.
Receiving a kidney transplant is wonderful.
But Pittman's immune system is suppressed to make sure her body doesn't reject that kidney she received 3 years ago.
And it doesn't mean that we're safe, even though we have been vaccinated. And to practice the CDC rules as if COVID was still fresh.
Pittman continues to wear her mask in public, but she knows that unvaccinated people might have shed theirs.
It makes me sad, and I do get frustrated.
Oldfield says he sees similar feelings among immunocompromised patients.
You're in this never-never land, and you don't know when it's going to end.
And without everyone getting vaccinated, that day is far out of reach.
If you're one of those people that say, well, you know, I'm not afraid of COVID. What you should do is get vaccinated to protect these other people.
People like Doris.
I need other people to be careful for me. Get the vaccine. Get it. Get the vaccine, please.
Now, if you fall into those immunocompromised or immunosuppressed categories, Dr. Oldfield shared some recommendations you can bring up with your physician. You can find those on wavy.com.